Hello everyone! Today let's talk about another Lithuanian tradition. This time, All Saints and All Souls Day in the beginning of November. It is mostly known as the days when everyone goes to the cemetery to light a candle. Many cultures around the world have some sort of tradition of commemoration of the dead, particularly at the end of October or beginning of November. I have no idea why. Do you? The Halloween in the United States on October 31st, Day of the Dead in Mexico, All Saints Day and All Souls Day in European countries on the first and second days of November, respectively. Lithuania celebrates this too in its own way. It is a time to think about death and to remember all who departed from this world. Although it is mostly a Christian celebration involving prayers during All Saints Day, in Lithuania, the day after, the All Souls Day, used to be celebrated even before Christianity became widespread in Lithuanian lands. The old celebration used to look much more like the Mexican tradition. People used to bring food to the cemetery for the souls to eat. They also sacrificed animals to pagan god Perkūnas and had a feast during which they shared the food with the poor. At night they used to open windows for their departed relatives to come to visit. Just like a similar tradition on Christmas Eve, leaving an empty plate on the table throughout the night for the souls to come to eat. These traditions stayed long after Lithuanians got converted to Christianity and dispersed only at the end of 19th century when a new tradition took over. Instead of putting food at the cemetery, people were encouraged to light candles. This tradition stays strong till this day. Now on the first and second day of November, you can see thousands of candles all over the Lithuanian cemeteries, of which people take so much care. Yes, Lithuanian cemeteries might look different to many, although neighboring countries also have similar style. Each grave is a little garden here, and the living family members take care of them meticulously throughout the year. While speaking of cemeteries, don't be mistaken about one famous place in Lithuania. The Hill of Crosses in Šilai district. While it contains thousands of crosses, it is not a cemetery. It is just a place where people bring their own crosses as a wish or a hope. But more about that in a later video about Šiauliai district. Now let's see some of the famous cemeteries around Vilnius. There is one cemetery that is the last home to many of the most famous public figures in Lithuania since the beginning of 19th century. It is Rasos Cemetery, and it is the oldest cemetery in Vilnius area. It can be quite interesting to walk around there with all the creepy old tombstones. Most famous people of the time were buried there, from dukes to artists, politicians and even revolutionists. There is a hill of literaries, where many writers were buried, and a hill of angels, dedicated to children. There are resting places of such figures as the patriarch of the nation, Jonas Basanavičius, most famous Lithuanian painter and composer Mikalojus Konstantinas Čiurlionis, and many others. But since the 90s, the burials of famous people moved to Antakalnis Cemetery, where many beautiful monuments were built to remember them. Many people visit Antakalnis Cemetery during the All Souls Day, and when I visited it, it was actually crowded to walk there. Cemetery is usually a place we avoid visiting if possible, but this is the day when we all ought to go there. It may feel scary, yet it is so beautiful, with all the candles quietly shimmering in the dark, as if each were a little soul. Because our dead are never dead to us until we have forgotten them. So let's not forget. Thanks for watching.